great to see everyone here this morning. Got a few guests with us. Daryl and his father-in-law, John. Daryl, you've been here one other time, I believe. It's great that you came back and brought your father-in-law with you. Hope you enjoy the service. Make sure you make him feel welcome. Also, Bonnie has her friend with her, Carol Swartz. Great to have you with us here. And it's always great to see Brother Sphinx. I haven't seen him in a while. He does ministry at campgrounds, right? It's great that he can come and visit with us here today. A couple announcements to go over. Next Sunday, right after the service, we're going to be having our chili contest. If you'd like to fix a pot of chili, there's a sign-up sheet out there in the foyer. We need you to sign up no later than Wednesday. So if you could sign up today, or if you come here Wednesday, you can sign up. But if you can get signed on there by Wednesday. Did everybody get a flyer? If you didn't get one and you need a flyer, raise your hand right now. Anybody need one? Okay. So even if you don't fix a pot of chili, stay with us next Sunday right after the morning worship service. Enjoy some food and vote, and we have a lot of fun. So please stay with us next Sunday for our annual chili contest. And that is for ages 8 and up. February the 10th at 2 p.m., Women's Ministry Valentine Celebration here at the church. If you could bring a finger food or dessert, again, that will be February the 10th, 2 p.m. here at the church. That's our Women's Ministry. And on February the 25th at 9:30, we're going to have another children's church meeting. So if you can come a little bit early on Sunday, February the 25th at 9:30 a.m., and we'll have a children's church meeting. Also, for all the board members, this Thursday at 1 p.m., we will have a board meeting. I'm looking at the one for February the 1st. Yeah, 1 p.m., I don't think we'd have a very good turnout. So next Thursday at 7 p.m. here at the church, that's just for the board members. That's all the announcements I have.
Praise the Lord. It's good to be in God's house this morning. Can we say amen? Amen. Amen. Let's stand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are we here to worship?
Yes.
We're here to praise.
Lord.
The Lord. Amen.
Amen.
How many is looking for some worship for yourself this morning?
My Lord.
Husbands, get your hands up. There you go. I know you're all looking for it. I'm one of them. Glory. Let's praise and worship the Lord. Can we do that this morning? Let's pray. Father, we thank you and praise you, Lord, for you are worthy of praise. And God, Lord, we've assembled ourselves today in your presence. God, we've assembled here to give you glory and honor, which is all due you today, God. And we just thank you and praise you for all things. Thank you, Lord, for what you brought us through this week.
Yes.
And Lord, in times past. And God, Lord, right at this very moment, what you're bringing us through. And God, Lord, as you tear it, Lord, what you're going to take us through. We thank you for that. And God, Lord, we just ask you to just accept our worship as a praise and a sacrifice unto you this morning. God, we just thank you and love you in Jesus' name. And everybody said amen. Shake hands with everybody. Make everybody feel welcome here this morning.
All right. I'm going to double up and shake your hand twice this morning.
That's okay.
I'm going to get you again.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. He knows my name. I've said this 100 times, I know. He knows every hair upon my head. In fact, he's got every one of them numbered. He knows when 53 fell out yesterday. He knows that much about me. Sometimes my question is, how much do I know about God? We simply need to believe. We simply need to trust. We simply need to believe in the promises of God. He said he wouldn't leave us nor forsake us. Glory. I want to go back to that second verse, Tiff. Because I don't have the answers to the questions of life. And I don't know a lot of things. I know a lot of things, but I don't know a lot of things in the grand scheme of things. But I do know that Jesus knows my name. He took stripes upon his back for my healing. Took 3 old rusty nails and some kind of calf horn in his back on the cross, that I might be saved, that I might have life eternal. He knows me. He knows my name. This morning you might be going through something. You don't have the answer to all the questions in life. And maybe you're going through something that you don't know anything about right now. God will reveal. God will reveal. We're going to sing that verse. If that's you this morning, you want special prayer. You want God to hear you. Whoa. It doesn't take a loud voice for God to hear you this morning. I do believe it takes a voice. Say this morning. Sometimes we can think God knows what's on our heart, and He does. But until we make it known, He has a hard time answering that need. Amen. That's good preaching, and I don't care who's doing it. Amen. Amen. Sometimes we need to let God know what's going on. Because at that point, and I love that song, I'm desperate for you. I'm desperate for you. Glory. Hallelujah. If that's you this morning, come forward. And let's pray that God will answer the need, that God will take care of the situation. God will let you know what you need to know. God will handle it. In Jesus' name. Glory. Glory. I don't know what tomorrow will bring. Can't tell you what's in store. I don't know a lot of things. I don't have all the answers to the questions of life, but I know even through my hand, He knows my name. Every step that I take, every move that I make,
Jesus.